Welcome to today's episode of my Let's Play of Pokemon Fire Red. I believe the agenda tip for today is fight Erica. Maybe maybe free Celadon from the control of Team Rocket. Yes, I would like... Nope! God dang it. I would, in fact, like to cut it down. Okay, cool. Just do it a little bit. A research for the moment. Okay, cool. So for this, we're just going to go... Corian. This gym layout is so boring. I forgot how boring this gym layout was. I suppose I could have Ancho out, and then we could do a... raise him up a bit. But I don't think he learns any new moves, really, that are worth the damn. Hey, 28. He learns Flame Wheel at 31. I don't think I'm gonna have an issue with him hitting 31 in this gym. I really don't. Okay. And I have a good backup, because I have Oriander. Oddish! Go Ancho! You got 3 levels on him. Her. 3 levels on her. The weakest fire move, and your special attack's garbage. Because for some reason, they decided that fire had to be special in frickin' Leaf Green and Fire Red still. I mean, it's like that in Gen 4 too, I think, so I guess it's okay for some reason. That's how we do it. Poison somewhat resists. No, it doesn't. That would be why it did die at one hit. I think Oddish just has higher special defense. Oh joy. Well, I have an antidote. So that's okay. Ancho is hurt by poison. I don't want to switch. So, Flame Wheel at 31, and then Flame Thrower at 49. And Arcanine learns no fire type moves. At all. There you go. You're not poisoned anymore, aren't you? Do I have a potion? I have a potion. Aha. There we go. She has so many trainers, though. This girl has 5 Pokemon? What? Poncho's gonna run out of freaking... Well, that's not what I wanted to do. That works. Gonna run out of flamethrowers. This might be me getting Honcho up a couple levels and then switching to Coriander to fight Erica. I mean, I guess that works. Not really what I wanted to do. No, Honcho! I mean, I have paralyzed heals, I think. And you can't be poisoned anymore, so that's good. Super potion. You're just a cool trainer. You're not supposed to have those. Listen here, bitch. Yeah, that's what I thought. That's not nice. Honcho is fully paralyzed. Oh, nope, I was wrong. Hey, 25. No, I'm good. For a second I thought that said comrade. I was like, what? Oh no, her special attacker is... neat. Ow, my face. Damn it, Honcho. Damn it, Honcho. Honcho. Yes, I will switch Pokemon. Go Coriander. Kick his butt. God dang it. Hey, I have an Ivysaur. It has a high crit chance. Unfortunately for you, Wing Attack has a high death chance. Damn it, Coriander, I said the cool line and everything, and you're just making me look like an idiot. Thanks for getting it on the turnaround, though. That's cool of you. Good job, Coriander. Oh yeah, I have to... I'll be back, ladies. Go, Kumin! Cut down that tree! Now we're all healed up. There we go. Let's go finish this off. Go, Kumin, cut down this tree. Deforestation. Oh hey, we don't like bug or fire type Pokemon here. Oh man, I guess it's really bad that I brought my fire dog. I didn't bring, mint or garlic, though. So, you don't have to worry about them. Mint and garlic are safe. At home. In the Pokemon. Yeah, that's fine. Hi, Gloom. Honcho, this is a Gloom. Burn it to hell. Oh, it's gonna take 3 embers. That's unfortunate. Does lowering my evasiveness do the same thing as raising your accuracy? I have to assume so. Why do I have to get hurt first? Because I went first? Because if so, that's BS. She got burned first. Dang it, Coriander. Dang it, Coriander, why are you always trying to steal stuff from Macho? No. No? I'm kind of insulted that you think so? Hey! Human is what you used to be. I used to have a Bulbasaur. Until mine evolved. Oh, you son of a bitch. That's not great. I mean, I'm not doing a... Not doing it. No item run this time, so I don't really care. All that did is make me use my awakening now. Which is moderately inconvenient, but whatever. Ivysaur! Ember! Three embers. A crit would hurt a lot. Burn. Damn it. God damn it. Didn't figure you're gonna wake up that time, aren't you? Yep, that's 18 from a regular hit. We ain't putting you in that shit. Go, Cory. That was cute. Rip his heart out, Cory. Hey. Ancho. What? I could have just gone around? I didn't know that. There we go. For this video to be entirely me taking on this gym, but I guess that's what this video is turning into. Flamethrower from the supermarket to give to Ancho. I'm an idiot. Trainer's Market, TV Game Shop, Wise Man Gifts, Drugstore. So, next one. How about you, bud? Oh, is it the gambling place that I get? Flamethrower from? Is that where I get flamethrower from? Okay, the prize thing's next one. Where do I get the the coin case? This guy? Figured it out. Oh, that has a menacing connotation. The Team Rocket guy is sitting out front of the restaurant. Let me go see charcoal of the other water. What about you? Abra, Clefairy, Dratini, Scyther, Porygon. $4,000 points. Okay. So, I have the coin case. The question becomes, do I spend the time and or money I have 34,000 Poké Dollars. So I can get 1,500 coins base, which is a good start. It gets me most of the way there. Or a good chunk of the way there. Do I spend the time and money to get Flamethrower before I finish taking on Erica? Because Flamethrower is a power 95 move. And Ember is a power 35 move, if I remember correctly. 40 move. So it's almost 2.5 times as powerful. Almost 2.5 times as powerful. So, that'll be the question of the day for this video, guys. Should I spend the effort to get Flamethrower before I fight Erica? Or should I clear out Erica before I get Flamethrower, and then just get Flamethrower and get it on Ancho afterwards, and then get the Dratini as well, because that counts as this in the Celadon encounter. But that'll be where we leave off today. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.